Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. If you are a beginner in using DaVinci Resolve or Fusion, you might want to do a follow text effect just like you see right here. And luckily, this is not too hard to do inside of the Fusion tab. So today, that is what I'm going to show you, and we're going to jump right into Fusion and take a look at how to do that. But before we do that, if you like this kind of content, do please consider to subscribe, like, and share. And if you really love the trick I'm giving you today and want to like donate me a cup of coffee, you can do that by pushing the thanks down below the video. Well, with that out of the way, let's get right to this tutorial. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and let's start to do this follow text. So first up, I'll go up to my effects library, and I'm going to take a adjustment clip, and I'm going to add that down to the timeline. I, of course, already did that. So with the composition selected, we're going to go into Fusion. And in Fusion, we have a background that is connected to the media out, and in between, we have a merge and a text node. And here we have the text. You are it, and we're going to make this follow effect here. We are going to go over here where we write our text, right-click on the mouse, and we're going to go down here and take this follower. So with that selected, now the modifier is enabled, and we can go into the modifiers. Inside of the modifiers here in the timing, we are going to change the order of things. And in this case, I want to go from left to right. I could also change it to random one by one, but let's go from left to right. With that done, I'll go into the shading tab, and I'm going to go down to the position right here. And now I'm going to set this thing up. So I want my composition to be here in my frame. This is a 20 frames per second timeline. So let's say frame 48, I want this to be right here. So I'm just going to, in the offset here, make a keyframe. And now you're wondering, what happened? Why am I in the path here? DaVinci does this every time. I don't know why, but we need to go back to our follower. And I'm just going to double click here on the follower one. Now I'm back. Now I can go to the first frame of our composition, and in the offset, I'm going to take my text out of frame like that. And now I'm simply going to go back to the timing here, because if I push the play, this is what we have, and that's not exactly what we want, because I do want to have some kind of movement. I want the text to follow each other up word by word. And to do that, of course, we have this left to right. We selected that just before, but we are going to go into the delay here of things. And the way the delay works, it's measuring this in frames. So how delayed are the characters to each other? So you can see if I change this around, you can see that it's going to be very much or less. So let's see if we can. What about 1.6 in frames? Let's have a look here how that looks. So it's like coming in. That's pretty cool, but I want to add in something more. So I'll do that by opening the spline editor. I'm going to select the text here, and then I'm just going to highlight everything, right click, and then I'll go into ease. And I'm going to take out back cubic. And let's have a look at what we have now. Something like that. Pretty cool. But maybe I want the animation to be a little bit less bouncy. So I'm just going to move things around with this handle, just dragging that down. And now we have this here. Cool. So that's more or less what I want, but I want to add one last little thing, which is going to be very cool. I'm just going to close down the spline. So if I go into the merge node and I go into the settings, I can then add in motion blur just like that. And now our little animation are going to have some kind of motion blur. There we are. And then, of course, if you want to have this on a transparent background, you would need to go into the background node, go up here in the inspector to the alpha, and simply just drag this all the way down. And this is going to be transparent. So when you go back to your editing page, you can have something like this. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.